My name's Larry Thompson. I work on radiation shielding for spacecraft. Z shielding is the combination of different elements arrayed together as one piece. Before, shielding has been done with multiple separate pieces of materials. And we're actually making one-piece structures where it has simpler geometry so that people can actually make them into shapes without the multiple pieces, and it helps with shielding edges and shaping. Could be extremely useful for CubeSats. Some of these CubeSats have been only lasting 3 to 6 months because right now they don't have much shielding at all. The addition of shielding would last these things up to 8 to 10 years in low Earth orbit. So for a company that's spending $100,000, say, for each CubeSat and $200,000 for a launch opportunity, and they're only getting 3 to 6 months of performance, this gives them multiple years, and so this helps bring CubeSats into more of a commercial sector than it's traditionally been. Some other applications: very thin shielding structures for medical X-ray detectors, possibly one application. Robotics. There's numerous companies in the robotics industry that are moving hazardous materials in the nuclear industry. Another is reducing the amount of people suiting up and having to go into the radiation environment. So if we're able to actually improve performance or the shaping properties of some of these applications, then it reduces the risks on people. NASA has envisioned seeing CubeSats go to Mars, seeing CubeSats go to the outer planets in the very harsh radiation environments. And NASA's looking at these as more cost-effective missions. Put a little bit of shielding in and increase the lifetime of the spacecraft. It's a no-brainer.
This NASA technology and many others are ready to be transferred to your business. Find out more by visiting technology.nasa.gov.